my name is Jessica Brown, known as Mama Brown, and I had preeclampsia during my first pregnancy, and I found out while I was in labor. When I got pregnant, I was already concerned. I had seizures for 15 years. I was diagnosed hypoglycemic and benign peripheral vertigo. I had had some heart surgery when I was little, and so my concern, of course, as soon as I got pregnant was, are they gonna be okay? Am I gonna be okay? And of course, that was my husband's concern too. The care that I received was from the Midwife Center of Birth and Women's Health. And so they, of course, collected all of that history, and with collecting all of that history, was sure that they would do everything that they could to make sure that I was safe, that baby was safe, and they reassured Dad as well. During the full pregnancy, I was doing pretty well. Sometimes, off and on, my feet would get swollen and things like that, but otherwise, I was feeling pretty good. And the day that I went into labor, my water broke. I was really relaxed and sort of intentionally paced myself, and at the midwife center, I could do that. I was able to get into the bathtub and breathe through contractions and all of that good stuff, and then real labor started. After all of that labor and that deep J breathing, my gift arrived. Right after my bundle of joy came out, they immediately said, you need to drink as much water as possible. And I didn't completely understand what was going on until after I was okay. So with that high blood pressure and having history of seizures and things of that nature, I knew the repercussion that if I were to have a seizure and the danger my baby would experience if I had a seizure while they were in my belly. So they told me, drink a lot of water, relax, relax. Baby is good, he's fine. We may need to send you to the hospital. Baby can go with Dad. We're gonna let you nurse, but this is what I need you to do. Breathe, relax, drink a lot of water. And so I drank almost a gallon of water right after having labor. My husband, of course, continued to pray, and I breathed. I tried to intentionally slow down and breathe. And in that amount of time of drinking a lot of water, slowing down and breathing, him praying, and them just really rallying around me of, Mommy did it, he's beautiful, you're gonna be okay, we're here, really allowed me to rest and relax my body. And of course, naturally, and with a first child, you don't know all the tension you're building up and how tight you're having your body get. My experience with preeclampsia was really a blessing to help me understand what I can do come baby number two and baby number three. The things that I could do to prevent the likelihood of me getting preeclampsia again. I increased my fiber, and that's what I would recommend to you moms if you're pregnant. Increase your fiber, increase your protein, get good antioxidants. So I did a lot of berries. Intentionally drink water and rest. I cannot emphasize the importance of drinking water and resting. And I'm one of those kind of moms who gets that energy to wash down walls before they have a baby, right? And I've learned through my experience with preeclampsia and really understanding how serious it was and why they were responding in the way they were, and that's the blessing, right? As soon as they knew, they were on it, and they continued to monitor me and keep me as comfortable as possible without me being panicked. But there was definitely a shift in seriousness to ensure that I was safe after they knew baby was safe. That because of their seriousness in monitoring me, and because they were paying attention and listening to the things that I felt, I was able to be in the clear. And so you get to go home within a few hours of having your baby at the midwife center if you are in good health and baby's in good health. So around 4 hours later, I went home. And so it was really what made all the difference in the experience was the environment, was the information. education that they were able to provide to my husband and the advice that they were able to provide to me, that they really emphasized the importance of relaxing and breathing and water without increasing anxiety and worry and tension, because that was the exact opposite of what was needed, right, for them to have me worried and then end up at the hospital because I'm tense, so, and my blood pressure has increased that much more. So I hope my experience has helped and provided some clarity on what can happen and what you as a mom can do to try to prevent some of those things from happening.